In 2013, TV Guide included The Price is Right in its list of the greatest game shows of all time. From intellectuals who otherwise binge on shows like Jeopardy and Wheel of Fortune, to school students and old people who regularly browse through channels to stop at anything interesting, The Price is Right is a show that appeals to every age group and section of society. The show's format is simple. Anyone who can guess the right price of common household items, such as a bottle of canned tomatoes, coffee, and shampoo bottles, takes home some easy cash. One may think that guessing the right price is easy, but ask the pricing managers and they'll tell you how difficult it is to pin down the right price of a product. If you're a fan of the show, you certainly have dreamed of hearing the line, "Come on down." The Price is Right is one of the most popular shows around the world, and through its 49-season-long run, the show has continuously bagged top ratings. The Price is Right was also the first show to break away from the normal quiz format. However, since its inception in 1956, the show has changed a lot. The Price is Right is not what you think. In this video, we'll tell you about how the show has changed over the years, as well as many other interesting facts about this hugely popular show that prove things aren't always as they look. The Price is Right debuted in 1956, and during the 50s and 60s, viewers were asked to send in their guesses about the prices of various items through postcards. Those who guessed right won. In his book, The Box, An Oral History of Television, Bob Stewart revealed that the show would get so many postcards, they had to hire housewives in Queens to open and check each postcard. Contestants have won all kinds of prizes in the show. However, in 1958, a man named Carl Slater struck it rich with his winnings. What did he win? A dining room set? A white Palomino horse, a suit of armor, and a trip to Scotland to get the armor. Amazing, isn't it? Well, don't be too surprised. In the past, audience members have also won things like a submarine, an island in St. Lawrence Seaway, and a Ferris wheel. We told you the show has changed a lot over the years, and thankfully so. Bob Barker has the distinction of being the Price is Right host with the longest run. He hosted the show for 35 years. However, he wasn't the show's first host. Bill Cullen, also known as the Dean of Game Shows, hosted it between 1956 and 65. Believe it or not, Cullen hosted a total of 23 game shows during his career. The Price is Right has a very catchy theme song. You listen to it once and you can't stop yourself from humming it all day. The song was created by Edward Woodley Kalehoff Jr., also known for creating many other hit theme songs, such as Double Dare, Monday Night Football, and PBS NewsHour. Winners sometimes have to wait for months before they can get their hands on their winnings. Why? The contestants are allowed to claim their prize only after the show has aired. Producers of the show once revealed that this is done to maintain excitement and thrill. In an interview, executive producer Mike Richards says they don't give away prizes to maintain a sense of surprise in the community. According to Mike, if a contestant won a car and took it home and showed it to everyone in the neighborhood before the show has aired, chances are people wouldn't be as interested in seeing the show. Are you surprised to know how long contestants have to wait to claim their winnings? Wait till we tell you about the taxes they have to pay. You'll never hear the show's producers talking about the taxes, as they're afraid any mention of the topic will hamper the show's rating. But we'll tell you all about it in just a minute. Meanwhile, if you're enjoying this video, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel. You might think guessing the price of commodities is one of the easiest ways to win money, but this is far from reality. Guessing prices of things is difficult, primarily because the prices of different things are different in different states. So how do the producers of the show decide the prices of various commodities they feature on the show? Producer Mike Richards revealed during an interview that to ensure there is price continuity, the makers of the show obtain the prices from a single retailer in California. Fans of the show think that one just has to wait for the line, "Come on down," to be said by the show's host to be able to win big money. The reality is different. One audience member revealed audiences have to wait for long hours in front of the studio's gate before they're allowed to enter. Once they finally get inside, the taping takes another few hours. So if you want to win on The Price is Right, make sure you have a lot of free time on your hands. Audience members aren't only required to spend hours waiting outside the studio, they're also made to clap a lot, especially during commercials. One audience member revealed that to keep the momentum going, they're asked to keep clapping during the commercials. This audience member further revealed that by the time the taping ends, most people go back with aching arms and palms. Speaking of the catchphrase, "Come on down," not many people know that the line wasn't supposed to be a catchphrase. It was just another line in a script given to Bob Barker. However, it was the show's announcer, Johnny Olson, who decided to deliver the line in an over-the-top manner. The audience reacted with equal fervor and excitement to his come on down calls, and the phrase stuck. Today, it's the first thing that people think of when they think of The Price is Right. The show has been on for close to 6 decades, and though many things have changed during this time, one thing about The Price is Right that has remained the same, and though many things have changed during this time, one thing about The Price is Right has remained more or less constant. The show is still old school and mostly features carnival-style games. One particular game called Freeze Frame is hand-operated by a man who hides behind the machine. On good days, this person operating the freeze frame is introduced to audiences, and when that happens, the operator makes a few extra bucks. Not just the games on the show, but also the set hasn't changed since 1972. The first episode of the present-day version of the show was shot in CBS's Television City in LA, and the show continues to be taped at that same location until today. Prize producer Eric Mills once said in an interview that other than the prizes on the show, everything about it has remained more or less the same. Bob Barker hosted the show for 35 years and is certainly the most popular host. So when in 2007 Drew Carey replaced him, producers were worried that the show would lose its loyal audience. Therefore, to keep up excitement, the creators of the show decided to change the games a bit to make winning prizes easier. In a blog post, producer Roger Dobkowitz explained, he and the other producers realized that for the show to stay popular, it was very important to make people win, at least during the first few weeks. So after Drew Carey replaced Bob Barker, the show went over budget by $700,000 in the first few months. When Drew Carey replaced Bob Barker in 2007, people were worried the new host wouldn't be able to live up to Bob's stature. However, over time, Drew has turned the show's loyal audience to his favor. How? Well, among other things, his decision to give away $500 from his earnings to anyone who makes the perfect initial bid certainly helped him win audiences and viewers. In 2017, CBS revealed that Drew had by 2017 given away $187,000 from his salary as cash prizes. Until 2012, The Price is Right, like most other game shows, hired female models. These models would stand next to the prizes up for grabs on the show. However, in 2012, keeping up with the times, the show hired its first male model. Rob Wilson was a Boston-based male model who got the job because he loved the show so much, he often faked sickness to stay home from school and watch it. Today, the show features many male models, with the most famous one being current presenter James O'Halloran, who won a nationwide casting call to become the second permanent male model on The Price is Right. Many people believe the winners on The Price is Right don't have to pay any taxes and take home the prize as winnings. The truth is, contestants do have to pay taxes, and more often than not, these taxes turn out to be massive. One contestant revealed they won $57,000 in prizes and had to pay $20,000 in taxes. Similarly, another contestant revealed winners have to sign proper paperwork regarding the taxes they must pay on their winnings. So, did you enjoy these facts about your favorite show? We bet you didn't know at least a few of them. Is there anything we missed that you'd like us to add? If yes, please leave a comment. We love hearing from you guys. Meanwhile, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to stay updated on all our latest videos.